persilakan yang amat berbahagia Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, firstly, thank you for your presence, especially now that it is 3 o'clock in the morning. Your organization, you are staying up late, like us. I would like to explain a little about this, some confusion about our party. As you know, we form a party called Pakatan Harapan, a coalition of 4 opposition parties. But the government managed somehow not to register our party. As a result of this non-registration, we had to decide on using just one symbol for ourselves. And we had to borrow the symbol of one of the legal parties, namely the Parti Keadilan Rakyat, the Justice Party. So we're using that symbol and in order to avoid confusion so that the voters will only look for one symbol. On the other hand, that symbol is the symbol of a party called the Parti Keadilan Rakyat or Justice Party. So that creates some confusion because some people thought that it was not Pakatan Harapan, not the coalition, but the single party was majestic. Then we have another decision made that we would leave Sabah alone to let the Sabah people contest as a Sabah party. But the understanding is that they are with us. So in the case of Parti Pribumi, my party, we decided not to go to Sabah because we have a working relation, spiritual relation with the Parti Warisan in Sabah. So the result is that we achieved majority long before the final announcement, because the announcement was made on the Parti Keadilan achieving the simple majority. That's why it took so long. But if you add to that the 14 more seats that was won by Warisan, then we would be much more in excess of the numbers that was announced. So we have in fact achieved a very substantial majority, not just a few votes, not just a few seats, but a very substantial majority. And since then, of course, we thought that there might be some problem apart from what I said earlier on, that they were very slow in announcing the result. But otherwise, things have gone fairly smoothly with some difficulties. And now the palace has contacted us. Because they heard that we have achieved a majority, but it's not official. They have not been told by the election commission that we have already achieved a majority. In any case, we are requested to inform the palace that we have achieved a a majority according to our own account. But later on, they wanted the official majority. And now that we have achieved the official majority, the palace requested that the leader of Keadilan Parti, Keadilan or the Justice Party, which happens to be Wan Azizah, Dato' Wan Azizah, who is also our designated Deputy Prime Minister. He's not yet our Deputy Prime Minister. And at this moment, we don't have a Prime Minister just yet. Until he swears. Not the usual kind of swearing. After the Prime Minister is sworn in and he's made Prime Minister officially, then he may appoint the Deputy Prime Minister and the other ministers. So initially he'll be quite alone. So in the next 3 days, and everybody else will have a holiday. Yes, around.
Has Najib accept the defeat?
I haven't heard from him. He's gone silent.
Can I ask what is the process for the next 3 days? While we are talking and you're working, what is the process?
Going to have the swearing-in ceremony of the Prime Minister. Yes. Then the Prime Minister, at his leisure, may appoint the Deputy Prime Minister and the other ministers. That's the process. Very simple. Yeah. They announce that once you reach 112, then you have a simple majority and you will form the government. It's the same for the state. Well, we'll work on it. will work on his pardon. He will be released in June, I think, 8th of June, and then we'll work for his pardon. Once he is pardoned, he is eligible to become a prime minister again, but he will have to stand for election in order to become a member of parliament. Because in our country, the prime minister has to be a member of parliament first, or at least a senator. As soon as possible.
Today.
I didn't realize. You know, I'm 93 years old.
Yeah. Government takes over. Will you charge Prime Minister Najib? I mean, ex-Prime Minister Najib.
We are not seeking revenge. What we want to do is to restore the rule of law. Anybody breaks the law, and that includes the journalists, they will be brought before the court to be tried. Thank you. Okay, I'll give a chance to the man behind. You've asked too many questions. And the Deputy Prime Minister and the Prime Minister in waiting. The rest have not been named. I have to manage with four presidents of four different parties. It's going to be a headache.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Be doctor!